الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعين به جل جلاله ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ به جل وعلا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا شيء مثله ولا شيء قبله ولا شيء معه، قديم بلا ابتداء دائم بلا انتهاء، لا يفنى ولا يبيد ولا يكون إلا ما يريد، لا تبلغه الأوهام ولا تدركه الأفهام ولا يشبه الأنام، حي لا يموت قيوم لا ينام، سبحانه لا مثل له ولا مثال له ولا مثيل له ولا مماثل له، ذلك بأن ربنا جل وعلا موصوف بصفات الوحدانية، منعوت بنعوت الفردانية، ليس في معناه أحد من البرية. وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وعظيمنا وشفيعنا ونور قلوبنا ونور أبصارنا وبصائرنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا أبا القاسم يا رسول الله، وعلى آلك يا حبيب الله، ورضي الله تبارك وتعالى عن صحابتك الغر الميامين، لا سيما الخلفاء الراشدون ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعن سائر السابقين الأولين من الأنصار والمهاجرين ومن اتبعهم بإحسان وتمسك بالثقلين إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد عباد الله، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. The ayah, as most of you know, is in Surah Al-Ahzab. And Surah Al-Ahzab is a surah that is distinguished, just like all the surahs of the Quran are distinguished. But Surah Al-Ahzab is very special because it goes through the times and it shows you the scenes where the Muslims and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were under subjugated to hardships, subjugated to many challenges, very rough time. And in Surah Al-Ahzab, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَبَلَغَتِ الْقُلُوبُ الْحَنَاجِرُ وَتَظُنُّونَ بِاللَّهِ ظُنَّا, the hearts are almost where the throats are. This is how fast they're beating. Tough time, challenge, that's when you distinguish. Usually in times of good, everything is good. But when things don't go as well, then you start separating the good from the bad. Surah Al-Ahzab sheds light on the situation and takes you through these scenes with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. Among the most important things that Surah Al-Ahzab distinguishes, specifically this ayah, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ, there's one thing that's very important. Number one, it shows us that Surah Al-Ahzab, or this ayah, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ, it means, the ayah generally means, there you have a role model in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ, for he or she, for that person who يَرْجُوا, يَرْجُوا means wants, or begs, or asks. يَرْجُوا اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ, and not only Allah, he wants Allah, he also wants the day of judgment, الْيَوْمَ الْآخِرِ. See, who wants Allah and who wants the day of the akhir? Not only that, وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. End of the ayah. This ayah comes as a refutation to those who say, النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم طارش. طارش means a delivery message. Man, just deliver the message. Is it just a delivery? No. Why do you glorify Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? Are you mushrik? Why do you love Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم? Are you giving him attributes of Allah? أَفَمَنْ يَخْلُقْ كَمَنْ لَا يَخْلُقْ. Is he who creates, the Quran says, is he who creates meaning, is he who creates, like someone who doesn't create? There is separation between al-Khaliq wal-Makhluq. There is difference between al-Khaliq wal-Makhluq. Al-Ayah came to say, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا. In Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, you have the best of examples. You have the infallible example. Because see, Islam is deen of Allah. And if you take Islam from people, people are not infallible. And therefore, their example could be wrong. But when you take it from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is infallible. Therefore, when you take it from him, you have taken it on the right way. The ayah came to glorify him, to say he's not just a delivery man. If you follow his footsteps, you go to Jannah. If you sleep the way he used to sleep, you go to Jannah. If you mention the way he used to mention, you go to Jannah. If you eat the way he used to eat, you go to Jannah. It's not simply a delivery man. No, no, no. Yes, Allah sent the Quran Kareem. Now, but as you know, sociologists, philosophers, and social science scientists, we call scientists, researchers, when they talk about facts, there's a process to analyze facts. You don't just say this is a fact. You start with theory, you collect data, it becomes a theory, and then it becomes a hypothesis. Hypothesis is a theory yet to be proven, and then you go from hypothesis to proving this hypothesis, then it becomes a fact, then you have a practical application of the fact, etc., etc. You deduce the way of deducing facts, etc., all these things. Al-Qur'an Azim is a fact. Nobody denies that. So we have the Qur'an. It's a fact. Yes. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us all to have a practical example. So you don't say, I only have words. I have only a book. Now you have a book and a practicing messenger. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ نُورٌ وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ. You have nur. النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وسلم nur. وَكِتَابٌ مُبِينٌ. And you have a clear book. You have a book, and you have a practicing example of this book that's inseparable from this book. Therefore, when Sayyida Aisha radhiyallahu anha, As-Siddiqa bint As-Siddiq, was asked, and As-Sahaba, after the passing away of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from this dimension to the next, they asked her, how was Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How was his morals? How was his moral standard? How were his ethics? She said, do you read the Quran? كَانَ خُلُقُهُ الْقُرْآنِ. If you read the Quran, you know how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was. As simple as that. It's a practical translation of Al-Quran al-Kareem. Therefore, anytime you get anything, or anytime there's an idea, but this idea is not practiced, or there is no practical application of this idea, of this theory, this idea dies. And then not only dies, it's impractical. It is inapplicable. Al-Qur'an as the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is applicable. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supplied you with these things, so you see these things as we go through. Let's go to Asbab al-Nuzul. And why the ayah was revealed, all these things. Al-ayah was in Surat al-Ahzab. In general, as you know, around the time of Al-Khandaq. We have the Battle of Badr, the Battle of Uhud, the Battle of Khandaq. The Battle of Uhud was a lesson, a very tough lesson to Muslims. What was the whole point of Battle of Uhud? Listen to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Listen to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't think it's just a... He's not saying like this, مَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. But people said, لَا يَنْطِقِ عَنِ. It means he doesn't say anything except wahi. But also he doesn't do anything except wahi. The battle of Uhud came to teach people that النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم what he says and what he does is all وحي خفي or ظاهر.
Either wahi comes and tells him his Quran
or al-wahi supports him throughout the time.